Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, honourable members, the House today stands to ratify railway and port lease agreement between the government of Sierra Leone and Kihu Railway and Port Company Limited. Mr. Speaker, honourable members, Sierra Leone will breathe a sigh for a comprehensive and detailed agreement. We might not have all of the brightest and finest legal minds, but Mr. Speaker, for the Honourable Minister to reach his conclusion of making a concrete agreement on behalf of the government of Sierra Leone with the approval of cabinet, and today we are about to ratify the document, will be a big economic boost for the people of Sierra Leone. We are talking of an agreement between the lessor and the lessee of a 200-kilometer railway from Pepper to Tocolini Mine. This is an agreement that will end the monopolistic tendencies of the past. Before this time, Chandon will create a whole monopoly. Nobody uses the railway. But with this new agreement, it makes the London feel that this is a 100% asset owned, amounting to about $1 billion. Can you imagine a big boost? Few years back, we are strangers to our very property in this country. Today, it is being owned by Sierra Leone. The lessee has a lessor. The lessee knows that this is a property that overnight. Mr. Speaker, honourable members, I have seen from the others of Parliament a 99-year-old agreement with little or no benefits. With this agreement, not 6 years. An interesting part about this agreement, Section 2, Section 3, 5, clearly put it out. Within these 6 years, the first 3 years, Sierra Leone has the authority to open a consortium or to call a manager to manage the joint mines if the lessee falters along the line. So you can see, before 2027 expires, Sierra Leone has the authority to call a consortium to manage this way. From the others, I understand that the lessor used to pay the lessee, rather, the lessee, which is the lender of the particular facility, used to pay about $250,000. Mr. Speaker, honourable members, it will also surprise you, from the 2020 and 2019 appropriation, the NNA, as well as the Ministry of Mines, the struggle to show how those monies were paid, $250,000. With this new agreement, Sierra Leone will benefit $1,250,000. You can imagine the disparity. You can imagine the disparity. $1,250,000. It's going to be a boost. Before this time, 10% amounting to $250,000 was handed in. Mr. Speaker, honourable members, even our newest friend, SMI, whom Marampa Mines, will be beneficiary to this particular facility. Before this time, it was monopolistically owned by just one company. But even our newest friend in the mining sector will also be beneficiary to ship out the Marampa 63 to 65 grade press. Can you imagine? Mr. Speaker, honourable members, this agreement also gives leverage for its expansion to Bumbuna as well as to Cambia as the years unfold. Which means several of our colonials will have jobs, will benefit, and one interesting thing, I remember the launch of the PEPEL some 6 months back. I remember that within that community of PEPEL, it is not only local content policy they are practicing, but local, which means even the community gives authority to the local people to form a village recruitment committee, which means they look within the village at all. If they have people with a technical know-how for a particular job, the company makes sure to exhaust that particular local before going out to look for the human resource. Mr. Speaker, honorable members, the agreement time does not permit us to look at the whole section of this agreement because it will spend this parliament to write a whole opinion. Mr. Speaker, remember Section 54 of the Mines and Minerals Act gives Sierra Leone the authority to get its assets that at the termination of a particular mining company, those assets belong to the government. And within a particular period, we are told that the public compensation will be paid by those that will take over in the home. And it was the whole debate. I must commend the minister. Upon taking his office as the Minister of Mines, those 3 days, 72 hours, with total psychological censoring, negotiating on behalf of Sierra Leone. Even the Chinese embassy came for more. They came for more because a Chinese coming, going out, and a Chinese coming, coming in. So now for it to become a loss, loss. But a win-win for both the Chinese and Sierra Leone, the minister must be commended. I think he deserves a standing ovation. Today, they have brought assets for Sierra Leonean and Sierra Leonean children, even for the future. And I also admire Schedule 1, Schedule 2, it gives a vivid description of the facility to the and also gives litigation and stabilizing clauses. This is very, very important. For an agreement to have stabilizing clauses, it gives the government of Sierra Leone authority at any time to any institute audits. So you see, it makes free the lessee very, very powerful as against the lessor, which means the lessor, we the lessor, very powerful as against the lessee of the asset, which means at any time, the government of Sierra Leone can institute or dictate, what's going on? Can I check this? Can I check that? Can I check that? This agreement gives us the authority to free trade, Section 18, Section 14 and 12. Mr. Speaker, honorable members, without saying much, I urge and I plead for honorable members within the committee and outside the committee to move with the fastest speed for the ratification of this agreement between the government of Sierra Leone and Tunisia.